On guys, so I actually have a bunch of my former colleagues who are now starting to study for step one, and they were asking me for some tips, and I figured I would share my tips with you because there are three big things that I think every single person who is signing up for the USMLE right now needs to be aware of and actually use. So I'm going to tell you about these three tips right after the intro. Let's do it. All right, so the three things that you need to make sure you absolutely do before you take your step one or even decide to start studying for your step one is to sign up for what I'm about to show you. The first thing is a practice session. A practice session allows you to go into a Prometric site of your choosing. Ideally, pick the Prometric site that you're going to be taking your step one at. And what they will do is actually physically walk you through the entire process. This means that you'll actually check in, you'll take a seat in the waiting area, then you'll be called up. You'll go through the whole patting you down, the whole metal detector, the whole like getting you your ID, signing in, signing out. They'll walk you through the whole shebang. And when you do this, the score that you get does not count for anything. It is just a practice session. Many of the test questions that you're going to get on this practice session are actually just sample questions. These are not real questions on the USMLE. They're actually sample questions. And the reason why this whole experience is actually worthwhile is because you get a feel for the room, right? And ideally, you should do this practice session about 1 to 2 weeks before your real testing session, because it will really allow you to be like, I know exactly where the bathrooms are at this testing location. I know who the people are at this testing location. I know how comfortable I feel. I know what the whole locker situation is, because Prometric does use lockers. So to sign up for this practice session, I'm going to include the link in the description below. But go there. You do have to pay $75 because the NBME will never lose a chance to monetize you. But pay $75 for your step one. You'll type in your scheduling number and your CIN. And when you enter this, you'll be able to essentially book a practice session. I highly recommend you do this. And it's best to do this early on to schedule your session. Schedule your session for like right before the day of your test. So that way you actually don't have to worry about it and it's just there and it's done. But some people, because you get so caught up in studying, if you don't do this from the beginning, can often miss scheduling this, and it can be really annoying and even frustrating to go there on the first day and not know what you're getting yourself into. So very, very underrated resource. The second thing is there are practice materials, and these are physical practice materials that have been released by the NBME. Right? UWorld is a great resource, but NBME is what is ultimately making the test. And believe it or not, they do have some sample questions online. Most of these are retired, but I have heard multiple accounts of individuals getting some level of repetition of questions, sometimes from the sample questions. So it is absolutely imperative that before you go in on your actual test day, you actually physically go through every single sample question, just because one, you'll get a feel for the types of questions they ask. And two, you will actually potentially even get lucky, and some of these questions may repeat on your test. And the last thing you want to do is miss a question that you know is already out there that the NBME has made accessible. So to get these sample items, I will link this in the description below as well, but you'll click sample items. When you click sample items, it will pull up this PDF, and you'll actually see that this PDF literally was updated in February 2021, which means some of these questions will be super, super, super recent, okay? And they can actually be very helpful in giving you the best indicator of what the real exam is like. Some people physically don't know this exists. Do not be one of those people. Make sure you do all of these sample questions before you go in on test day, just because you want to make sure you're not missing any easy questions, right? For example, some of these questions may actually be really tough. But if you did them before you went in and you got a similar question or even the exact same question, you'll get it right and it would save you so much time. So just my two cents, please do the sample questions. Some people forget that these exist. Definitely do them because they are the most indicative of the real exam. Primarily if they're updated this recently, like February 2021, that's huge, okay? Now the third, and this one is probably the most important, but also the most subtle. The third thing is to get very used to the interface, okay? And these questions are, again, all freely available on the NBME website. To access this, you actually can just go to like this website again and then click on the tutorial. And when you click on the tutorial, you can physically do this. And don't physically do this question per se, but I do want you to go on this website and work through the general format and understand what the format is like. Because some people get used to UWorld And although UWorld format is very similar to the one that you'll actually see on test day, there are some small nuances. And so it's important that you actually just understand this format right here and now. Another small nuance that I will point out is if you go to the link I'm posting in the description below, the USMLE practice materials link, and click this tutorial, you'll be here. And then after that, if you click this, you can actually physically walk through the step one tutorial that you will see on test day that will physically tell you what you're going to expect. And the good part is if you do this before your test, you will save so much time that you can skip through the tutorial, and that way you'll have extra time to take on break. So that is ultimately what I wanted to say today. These three tips are really imperative for you to do before you actually go to take your test, because they'll save you a bunch of time and up your score in a very high way. First of all, you want to make sure that you're doing your practice session, which I'm going to link below. The second thing is you want to make sure you're doing your sample items because, again, they're very new, very updated, and could potentially show up on your test. And the third and most important thing is to get used to the tutorial and the overall exam interface, which is also available on the NBME website, all of which is linked below. Thank you all for listening. I hope this was helpful. If it was, drop a like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.